Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to explore more on Power BI Desktop. If you are new to this channel, please do subscribe to watch more on Power BI. And if you don't know how to install Power BI Desktop, please watch my previous videos. Let us explore our business scenario. A guy running a garment shop, he owns in Chennai. And he sells men's casual wear, ladies' casual wear, and also accessories. For him, we are trying to build dashboard. Today's topic, it's all about more on Power BI Desktop. So we're going to see all these options, visuals, fields, filter, tabs, and how to transform data. Let us see by example. And first, visual, fields, and filter. So in visuals, you see a lot of visuals here. We are going to see each and every visual. Let us quickly change a chart, this pie chart, by a bar chart. So for that, click on the chart and click on column chart. So it is that simple, guys. If you want to change the chart type, then quickly we can switch between the charts. Any charts you can choose. Let's see on fields. Fields, you have a table. Underneath, you have what are the columns available. And if you have multiple tables, that table will be displayed under this level. This is the data at level table, and you have other tables displayed in this level. So we have only one table here. Next, we see about filters. Let us switch back to pie chart. And filters just is like filtering the visuals or filtering the page. So you can choose on visuals or either page. It's up to you. Based on the scenario, we will go for it. Now let us see by example. Let us filter by category. So list of categories available in that shop is available. Accessories, he sells casual wear, semi-formal, as we saw. Now, when we choose any of the filters, automatically all this will filter for this category. So in the formal category, there are shirt, arrow, and shirt. That is unbranded shirt available. So other visuals also filters. Now let's see casual wear. So it also filters, the entire page is filtered based on the click filter, whatever you applied. So this is about filters. Let's explore tabs. So this is, we are on currently report tab. And we can have a report tab plainly over here when I click on new page. So this is our report tab. And we have other tabs like data. Data, you can see your data. I mean, view it. When you find anything fishy, the data is not good or something is going wrong, then you can see there. That is about your data. And you have anything, some data type issues, or some, instead of 900 it should come as some other value. If you feel that, you can explore it. Let's see in model tab. In model tab, you don't find anything useful right now, because since we have only one table, and whereas you have multiple tables, you create relationship. So let us see by example. I have here a fact, sales quota, and dim employee, where dim employee and fact are related, and dim date and fact are related. So when you filter by dim employee, the data in the sales quota will filter. So this is what your modeling is all about. Now the last is your transform data. Let's see by example. We can transform using use Power Query Editor to connect, prepare, transform the data. So this is where you can transform the data. Meaning, like always, a business scenario, you will not get the data as such, it's suitable for reporting. People will have to transform. So, you consider here the jeans, Levi's jeans, denim, jeans, Zara. The business owner, the garment owner, wants to see the brand name wise. Brand wise, he wants to compare the results. So, we need to remove this jeans, jeans, jeans part, hyphen part. So, with this scenario, how can we transfer? So you can see the data here. It is same. And let us explore by transforming a data. So the item name column is available here. So here I can transform the same existing column, but I don't want to do it because I need for other reference. I duplicate it. And one of the option in Power BI is that you don't need to do any coding kind of stuffs where you need to specify the logic, and the Microsoft guys will taken care of. I mean, they will, the Power BI tool will take care of that coding part. That is the purpose of this tool. So the logic is I need to split by the hyphen. Whenever you see hyphen, you need to split for the split column by delimiter. Then here, the Power BI automatically sends it. The hyphen is considered as a delimiter here in this data. Whether you want to go by that. Yes, I want to go by that. I don't want to change anything over here. And then you press OK. That's all. It's as simple as that. I got my brand separated and the initial part, the left-hand side part separated. I will rename it as brand. So we achieved what we want. We transform the data. Then you need to close and apply. That will save these changes and apply into your report. So the new column that we created will reflect in the data. Here, the new column appeared. Instead of this item name, I want to view by brand name. So click on the chart. Then we will remove this item name and replace with brand. So we got it what we want. We transform the data. So it is this simple, guys. So this is so powerful tool. If you like this video, please subscribe to this channel and do remember that data is your asset.